हेलो गाइस, आई होप एवरीवन इज़ फाइन. इन टुडेज वीडियो वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट रिकर्सिव एंड इनम्यूरेबल सेट्स. वी आर गोइंग टू फर्स्टली डिस्कस अबाउट द डेफिनेशन ऑफ दिस. सो द सी ऑन द बोर्ड वी हैव रिटन सेट एस इज सेट टू बी रिकर्सिव इनम्यूरेबल इफ देर इज़ अ प्रोसीजर टू फाइंड द एलिमेंट बिलोंग्स टू एस और नॉट. सो क्लियरली अ रिकर्सिव इनम्यूरेबल सेट इज अ पर्टिकुलर सेट दैट इज set to be recursively enumerable if there is a procedure to find whether that set is belonging to a language or not. So you will be given a set, you have to find through a particular procedure whether, and we have to check whether it belongs to a language or not. It means a string will be given to you and you have to basically test that string whether that string is belonging to a particular language or not. So there is one example which is given to you. The language, the question is that you have S which is a starting symbol and it is having particular rule 0S A12. S is given as 012, 2A1 is given as A12, 1A1 is given as 11. So these are all production rules. We have A1 and A2, these are non-terminals. You have terminals as 0, 1 and 2. You have production rules which are given to you and you have a starting symbol S. Now we have to basically check whether 00112 is a part of this grammar or 001122 is a part of this grammar or not. So if there is a procedure to find whether these are acceptable by languages or not, that means these are recursively enumerable. So there will be one set which is not going to belong to this language and there will be one set that will belong to this particular language. But if there is a procedure to find that particular scenario, we can say that is recursively enumerable. So we have initially, because you have S as a starting symbol, it has already given as 012. So 012 is definitely a part of this particular language, since I told if minimum possible string is given to S. So you have a starting of that entire scenario with that particular string. So you want 012 is the start for this particular scenario. So S is given as 0S A12. This A1 and this S, you can put some certain values accordingly, but S value is given as 0S A12. S value can be taken as 012. Right, and then we have got A1 and 2. This is also given to us. Now importantly guys, there is some value for 2A1. Just see, 2A1 is generating A12, so I am writing A12 over here, right? And 1A1 is also generating 11. If I put 11 over here, I clearly get 00 11 22. So it means there is a procedure to find 001122, which is my second particular language. And if you can see clearly, this is a pattern, 101112, 201122s. So similarly, there will be other patterns also. It means my language would be 0 power n, 1 power n, 2 power n, n greater than equal to 1. Because you started with minimum value of n as 1. Clearly this is a recursively enumerable language and there was a procedure to find 001122 as a part of language. Obviously 00112 will never belong to this language because we never got that string from our procedure. So this is regarding recursively enumerable language. For context sensitive language this procedure is useful, as well as for your unrestricted languages also. So that is what recursively enumerable set is all about. If you like this video, kindly press the like button, kindly like, share and subscribe and reach maximum people. Thank you very, very much.